100 people. That's louder than some stadium shows. I was thinking I could play some songs. That's okay. I'm just checking to make sure that this is in the right key, because I've had this issue lately where I start a song and then I have to start it over with, which is sort of a recurring issue I used to have when I was like 14. It's come back. So, anyway, this is called Gorgeous.
You should take it as a compliment that I got drunk and made fun of the way you talk. You should think about the consequence of your magnetic field being a little too strong. And I got a boyfriend, he's older than us. He's in the club doing I don't know what. You're so cool, it makes me hate you so much. Everyone here but you. And you should think about the consequence of you touching my hand in a darkened room. If you got a girlfriend, I'm jealous of her. But if you're single, that's honestly worse. Cause you're so gorgeous, it actually hurts. Ocean blue eyes.
You guys are incredible. This is so fun. I want to say really quickly that AT&T DirecTV Now, they put on this party for us. Like, everything that's gone on. They built this stage. They basically constructed all of this so that you would have a good time. And, you know, just the entire party that you were at before the doors opened up and you realized it was also a concert. They put so much work into that. They put so much effort into it. There were so many, like, cues taken from music videos and lyrical puns and fun things that they created. So let's give a round of applause to them for us. Very nice of them to do that. Yeah, so this next song is a song that I wrote about. I was thinking a lot about the concept of a reputation, because I knew very early on I wanted to name the album Reputation. It was one of the first things. So I was able to really kind of construct the album based on that concept. Usually, every time before, I think I've kind of come up with the title of the album pretty late in the process. So I'd be like, what are all these songs? What do they all kind of have in common? What's a word I use a lot? What? And so this one was different because I kind of built it out from the concept of a reputation. So there are a lot of like I'm angry at my reputation moments. There are like, I don't care about my reputation. I'm fine, okay? I don't care. And then there are these moments where it's very like, oh my God, what if my reputation actually makes the person that I like not want to get to know me? Like, oh no, that's a reality that could happen. Like, and so when I was thinking about that part of it, where like your reputation, you're like, how real is it? Well, it's only real if it stops you from getting to know someone where you feel like you could connect with them in a really real way. So this is a song I wrote about that. And actually, I just found out that this song is top 5 at pop radio and number 1 at Hot AC radio. So that's really nice. And so
this ain't for the best. My reputation's never been worse, so you must like me for me. We can't make any promises now, can we, babe? Cause you can make me a drink. 1, 2, 3, let's go, baby! Top bar on the east side, where you at? Phone lights with my nightstand in the black. Come here, you can meet me in the back. Dark jeans and your Nikes, look at you. Oh damn, never seen that color blue. Just think of the fun things we could do. Cause I know that it's delicate.
Written, and I think for me it's super relatable.
I was just amazed that somebody could put what you feel when you have a crush on somebody and you want to tell them into words.
I love her innovativeness, how she has grown through her music, how she shares her personal life with us, and she hits the spot, you know?
You know, it's interesting looking back on writing a lot of songs about my life, because when I first play it live, I'm like obviously thinking about that experience that I had that inspired the song, that basic initial kind of experience that I had that I was writing about. And then it kind of over time it morphs, because like, first of all, time helps you get over things, right? It's like one, you hope, hopefully. That's the dream. But basically, I think that as time passes, what's so weird is that like my memory that I relive when I think of a certain song or when I play a certain song changes from being about a person that was in my life or an experience I had originally, and it kind of morphs into like times I've played the song and heard you singing it back, like super loud. So there's a song that I wrote that that thankfully you guys seem to like, which is so nice. And it's a song that originally it was a song that like every time I'd play it, I'd be like, ugh, like, ow. And now I play it and I think of like the times I've played it in a stadium or an arena or my living room with you guys screaming the words back to me. And so it changed it. And I wanted to thank you for changing it, because it's kind of nice to sing a song that you're proud of, but not feel pain while you sing it. Very nice. So with that in mind, this is called All Too Well.
Singing in the car, getting lost on the stage.
little kid with glasses in a twin size bed. Your mother's telling stories about you on the T-ball team. You told me about your past, thinking your future was me. And I know it's long gone, and there was nothing else I could do. And I forget about you long enough to forget who I am. I feel like it works sort of in a linear timeline. I feel like it starts in a certain place. It's like the album is sort of like a catharsis where, like, after I wrote it, I was like, oh, okay, wow, okay, so that's done. Like, but I had to say all of it because it really, I was feeling a lot of feelings. And so the album starts out and it's all very, like, bombastic and grr, 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 like, and... it's really like, I think that there was a bit of a bait and switch that happened with this album when we put out Look What You Made Me Do, and we're like, guys, this album's gonna be one thing. And when the album came out, it's legitimately an album about finding love throughout all the noise. And so it starts with the noise and how that all makes you feel, and how it makes you feel when, like, when people are saying things about you that you feel like aren't true, and living your life sort of in defiance of that, in defiance of your reputation. And then sort of in the middle of the album, you kind of realize, okay, so what, how much do I really value that? Like, if you can find something real in spite of a bad reputation, then isn't that what matters the most to you? And doesn't it matter the most to you that you know who your real friends are now? Doesn't it matter? So, I found myself, like 2 New Year's Eves ago, I felt myself in the midst of a very, like, incredible 3 a.m. moment where you feel like you're invincible and you end up, like, jumping in a pool in the winter. And you feel super untouchable in that moment, and then the next morning you feel very fragile. And you're like, this is love. This is what love really is. Like, we all want to find someone to kiss at midnight. That's cool or whatever. But who's going to want to hang out with you the next day when you're like, Advil or nothing? Like, so this is a song about finding real love and finding someone to hang out with on New Year's Day.
Hold on to the memories they will hold. whole message of, you know, who do you want to like hang out with the next day after the party's over, and who's really there for you, who really has your back. And whenever I hear that song, I think of my friends, I think of my family, and it's really emotional to hear her play it, and to get to hear it in such an intimate setting is a priceless experience.
To see her in stadiums and then to see her like right in front of you in an intimate setting is incredible.
My heart was just pounding out of my chest. Like, she's amazing.
Thank you so much, Taylor Swift. We love you.
This is a song I don't do a lot acoustic, but I'm gonna try and see how it goes. So, this is called Shake It Off.
The